So,
fun part, we're going to move on to building your shop. All right. So before you begin, it can be helpful to gather a few things. It just sort of depends on your style, but if you have these things together, it will make building easier and more straightforward. So you're going to need pictures of the items that you want to sell. And it can be helpful to have a variety of pictures of the items, depending on what they are. If they're just fairly straightforward and two-dimensional, a single picture might be enough. But if they're physical items, sometimes having pictures from different angles is helpful. It's helpful to have a description of these items if you want that on your site. It's very helpful to write all of these beforehand. It's helpful to have thought about what you want to price your items at, and you'll also have the ability to identify a sales price if you would like. You need to know how many of the items it is that you're putting up for sale on your site. And then it's helpful to have some idea about the web domain that you want to use. When you set up your Squarespace site, Squarespace will give you a default domain. They sort of string together strange words, and that will be your domain, and you can certainly use it if you don't attach another domain to it. The problem is that no one will ever be able to find you if that's what you use. So some idea about the domain that you want to use, the domain name, is very helpful. And as we'll see, if you buy the one-year subscription to Squarespace, it comes with a year of domain hosting, although you are also totally able to connect your own domain if you have an outside domain. That is, in fact, what I did with mine. You're going to need a credit card to pay for everything, although, again, you are given a 14-day free trial with any site that you start to build. So you definitely don't need to commit yet. There are a few features that you can't have access to until you pay, but for the most part, with the 14-day trial, you can actually more or less build your site up before you even need to pay anything. And I'll also add here a neat trick that I learned. If you wait till near the end of your 14-day free trial, at least for me, Squarespace sent me a message asking me if I wanted an extra 20% off. So if you want that coupon, just wait for the 14-day trial to get close to expiring. All right. So now we're going to quickly go over the costs and features of Squarespace plans. The two that we're gonna most likely be focusing on are in the middle. The $18 business plan, which is identified as the most popular there. That gives you basic e-commerce functionality. We see that in the top part of the picture, it has everything that the basic commerce package has. If we scroll down, we start to see where the business and the basic commerce package start to divide away from each other. The business package has a fully integrated e-commerce, has a 3% transaction fee. You can sell unlimited products on your site. You can accept donations and have gift cards. However, you need the basic e-commerce site to have access to a point of sale system, customer accounts. If you want checkout to be on your domain instead of through a third-party domain, and if you want access to their analytics, I will just sort of leave that up to you. Maybe in consultation with an SBDC advisor, which option works best for your business. Certainly, if you start with the just regular $18 a month business plan, you can upgrade if you find it is not functional enough. Similarly, I suppose if you started with the basic commerce plan, you can downgrade if it has more than you need. These prices are for a year's membership. And that is where the annual savings comes when you pay for a year. Another important thing to keep in mind is that if you're going to use Squarespace to find your domain, you need to pay for the one-year plan to have access to that. If you just pay month by month, they don't give you access to the free custom domain. That being said, it's very easy to go get your own domain, so certainly don't let that stop you if you're worried about it. And then we see an overview of some of the other differences between the pages. And if you just want a personal website without the e-commerce options, that is on the left for $12 a month. Although I assume that is not where we are at today. All right. I'm going to pause and ask if there's any questions about the pricings or the options before we move on. Okay. So now I'm going to go over an example of how to build a shop from the very beginning. So we'll remember our Nick's Microphones page here. And if we click on pages, this gives us an overview of the parts of our website. We see we have work, shop, blog, and contact, and those are mirrored here, work, shop, blog, and contact. So these are the different sections of our page. And what we're going to do is we're going to reorganize these. So this page was set up to be a collection of this artist's work. That's not quite where we want to go. So we're going to kind of rearrange things. So when you hover over the work button, you get a little gear there. When you click on the gear for each of the main navigation items there, you get the settings for that page. So this happens for work, shop, blog, and contact. We click on the gear, we get the portfolio settings here, and we see some details about the page. We see the page title, the navigation title, the URL slug, which is how it's identified on the internet. We can see if we have enabled the page and made it visible, and we can add a password if we want. If we scroll down, we can also see the ability to either set this as our homepage or see that it is set as our homepage. So what we're going to do is we're going to rename this microphone specifications and change the slug to specs. And then we'll see that it changed up here. All right, microphone specifications, and over here, microphone specifications. So what we're going to do now is rearrange these because I don't want this to be our homepage, or I want the shop to be our homepage. So we're going to pull it down, click on it, and pull it down to the bottom. You'll see it's at the bottom now. Now we're going to click on shop and click on the gear and do a little bit of renaming. So we're going to rename the shop our homepage. So we see that we changed the page title, the navigation title, and the slug from shop to home. There we go. And then we're going to scroll down and we're going to set this as our homepage. It'll ask us if we really want to do that. We'll confirm. And now when we click on what is now the homepage, we will be greeted with a page we'll see in a minute. Sorry, we'll get there. But before we move on, we're going to delete the blog section because we don't need that. So we see blog here. If we click on the garbage can, it'll allow us to delete that. We'll confirm it and it's gone. Now we see we just have the three sections, home, contact, and microphone specifications.
Thank you for watching our video. If you would like to speak with a business advisor at no cost to you, please feel free to reach out. We're the Small Business Development Center at Blue Mountain Community College. Please attend one of our workshops, either virtually or in person, or just give us a call. Thank you.